Good evening, my dear viewers. Welcome to my YouTube channel. This is Aditi Banerjee. So now I am going to focus on a poem which is there in class 9 and 10 of ICSE board, that is After a Blenheim, written by Robert Southey. So I am going to tell something about Robert Southey. English poet and biographer Robert Southey was born in Bristol, England in 1776. He was made poet laureate or court poet in 1813. Along with Wordsworth and Coleridge, Southey also formed part in Lake School of Poets. They were called Lake Poets. Between 1796 and 1798, he wrote many ballads, including The Battle After Blenheim. So written in the form of a ballad, After Blenheim, which is also known as The Battle After Blenheim, offers deep insights on war and its consequences. So before I start the poem, I'd like to request all of you to please like, comment, share and subscribe my channel. And please press the bell icon for more videos. So let's discuss the poem. After Blenheim by Robert Southey is an anti-war poem that centers around one of the major battles of the 18th century, the Battle of Blenheim. Blenheim is the English name for the German village Blenheim, situated on the left bank of the Danube River in the state of Bavaria in southern Germany. Southey here ironically represents the absurdity of war from a layman's perspective. So now I am going to explain stanza wise. Stanza 1. Stanza 1 begins by picturizing a vivid description of a summer evening. We encounter Casper, an elderly farmer who was sitting in front of his cottage door watching his grandchildren Wilhelmine and Peterkin at play on the lush grain field. Stanza 2. Wilhelmine saw her brother Peterkin was rolling something that was large, smooth and round. Peterkin had discovered the thing by the side of a rivulet while he was playing there. He came back home to know what the thing was. In the third stanza, Casper took the thing from Peterkin and shook his head. He finds it to be a skull of some poor fellow who died in the war. In the fourth stanza, Casper's father added that he found thousands of skulls when he went to plow his garden. Casper referred to it as a great victory. Commoners like Casper took it as a great achievement of the nation. In the fifth stanza of the poem, the grandchildren ask their grandfather about the hidden reason behind the war. Little Wilhelmine looked up to her grandfather in anticipation with wonder-waiting eyes. In stanza number 6, Casper said that it was the English who turned their fury on the French and inflicted much death and destruction. But he was unable to say what triggered the war. In stanza number 7, Casper recollected the events of the war days. His parents had to flee with children to save their lives. Stanza 8 highlights the horrific aspects of war. The symbol of fire and sword embodies the evil spirit of human cruelty and destruction. Men, women, some of them pregnant, children, all perished. So in the poem, the irony is made evident by Casper as he says that these things are meant to happen at every battle where there is a great victory. In stanza 9, the poet Robert Southey, through Casper, goes on to describe the agony of war. There is no dignity, no glory in war, only misery. Countless dead and decaying bodies lay under the sun. After all, it was a great victory. In stanza 10, Casper said that the Duke of Marlborough won and brought glory to his people. But Wilhelmine confused and exclaimed that the war was a weak thing. In the last stanza, Peterkin asked his grandfather what good came out after such misery. But Casper was unable to tell and kept repeating that it was a great victory, it was a famous victory. Thus, the poem After Blenheim depicts the poet's message that war is something which must be avoided, as all it brings is more destruction and dissatisfaction to this cruel world. So that's all for today. Thank you for watching my videos. See you in the next videos. If you like this video, please do like, comment and subscribe. Thank you. Bye-bye.